never can assume thanksgiving. Please make it a lifestyle to give God quality thanks for every good thing in your life. And every waking day, there are several good things in your life. If just a nail on one of your fingers has a challenge, maybe you won't be in church this morning. Just the fingernail. One. Just one fingernail. Maybe you won't be in church this morning. Father, as a people, we have returned this morning for all the wonders you do in our lives, too numerous to be counted. We have returned like that one leper to say, Father, we are grateful. We acknowledge your mighty hand upon our lives. You are the doer of all the good things that we celebrate. You are the reason for our existence. Father, thank you. Father, we give you praise. Father, we magnify your holy name. Lord, as a university this morning, we say thank you for all the great report that we have been receiving, especially since this year began. Lord, be thou exalted in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Almighty God. Blessed be thy holy name. In Jesus' great name, we have given thanks. In Jesus' great name, we have given thanks. Ask the Lord to send to you your own word this morning. There is a particular word meant for each one. Ask the Lord, Lord, send my own word to me today. I don't want my coming here to be in vain. Give me an encounter with the power in your word. Lord, by your word, fill the void in my life. Almighty God, give me an answer of peace by your word this morning. In the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we ask of you, do for each one according to the desire of his or her heart. In the name of Jesus Christ. Almighty God, Holy Spirit, the greatest teacher of all, we call upon you to minister the word to each one of us this morning. Power the word to gain access into each heart. Let every impediment be cleared off. Let every stony heart be converted to the heart of flesh. In the name of Jesus Christ. Let the impact of the word become visible upon every life. Thank you, Almighty God. Glory be to your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Your word said you sent your word, and your word healed them. And the same word delivered them from all of their destruction. By the power of your word today, heal the sick. Set the oppressed free. Break all chains. Lift all burdens. Break all yokes. Set your people at liberty to the glory and the honor of your name. In Jesus' great name, we have prayed. Amen. Please put those hands together for the Almighty God. And please be seated in his presence. It is my new dawn era. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. We can never thank God enough. The Lord deserves our praise. The Lord deserves our gratitude. Every waking day of our lives, please always lay it to heart to give God thanks for his hand in your life. Without his hand in your life, you won't be here. Without him in our lives, no one will be here this morning. That is why he works all of the time. And he works to keep us alive. Glory be to God. We began the teaching series this month on our Sunday worship service platform titled Foundations for Supernatural Breakthroughs. Because according to 1 Corinthians chapter 3 and verse 11, The Bible says, for other foundations can no man lay than that which is already laid, which is Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ remains the only viable, dependable, reliable, sustainable foundation upon which the destiny of anyone can be built. He remains forever the only authentic foundation, the foundation that has the capacity to withstand the storms of life. That foundation is Jesus Christ. That foundation is Jesus Christ. And this morning, we will be looking at two critical foundations. One, the power of faith. In other words, the foundation of faith. And number two, the power of meekness. In other words, the foundation of meekness. And when a man possesses these two foundations, he can withstand every storm of life. Faith is the power that rules the world. Faith is the power that rules the world. It is the currency that is acceptable in any nation. Faith can make anything happen for anyone, at any time, at any place. Now, meekness sustains what faith has acquired. Meekness sustains what faith has acquired. So, these two powerful forces can make any destiny. These two powerful forces can convert any trash to treasure. And I trust the Lord God of heaven this morning to minister this grace to each one of us in the name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We understand that the foundation for assessing all the provisions of the kingdom is as established in Scripture. In other words, this book of the law, according to Joshua chapter 1 and verse 8, is the foundation upon which anyone can assess any scriptural provision. Anything that is provided for by God is accessible through this book. Anything that is provided for by God is accessible through this book. Because God will not do anything for any man outside the provision of this book. God will not do anything for anyone outside the provision of this book. That is why the more of this book you know, the more of God you assess. The more of this book you engage in your journey of life, the more of God you have access to. When this book of the law does not depart from your heart, when it is not written just in your head, but it is ingrained in your heart, and it becomes the instrument with which you navigate the rough seas of the world, then you have access to everything that is available in God. You have access to everything that is available in God. This book is so critical that Jesus Christ himself, the scriptures makes us to understand, they call him to read the Bible in the temple. And he opened the scripture and he read the place that was written concerning him. In other words, even this book contains the life and times of Jesus Christ before he was born. That is how topical, that is how critical, that is how vital, that is how inevitable it is for us to dwell in this book. If we ever want to make a success of our destiny. So the foundation of this book ensures the solid foundation for anyone's destiny. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. In 2 Peter chapter 1, beginning from verse 2, the patriarch Peter wrote, he said, grace and peace be multiplied unto you through the knowledge of God and of Jesus our Lord. So the knowledge of God and of Jesus Christ multiplies grace, multiplies peace. The knowledge. And how do you know God? How do you know Jesus Christ? You know God through his word. And the Bible says his knowledge multiplies to you grace and peace. In verse 3, the scripture says, according as his divine power hath given unto us all things that pertain unto life and godliness through the knowledge of him that hath called us to glory and virtue. All things that pertain unto life and godliness is captured in this book. All things, your financial things, all things, your medical things, all things, your peace things, all things, your family things, all things, your academic things, all things, your wisdom things, all things, your social things, all things that pertain to life and godliness, your peace things, all things, your fulfillment things, all things, your success things, all things, your righteousness things, all things, making peace with your God, all things that pertain to life and godliness. Everything that makes life meaningful is packaged in this book. What you don't know about it is what you suffer for. It's just what you don't know about it is what you suffer for. Recently, the Holy Spirit has been dealing with, I've been asked, I said, Lord, a number of questions that come my way. You know, there is no one that can provide answer to all the questions in your life. It's not possible. And I said, Lord, what is it? And then the Holy Spirit opened my eyes and said, no, these individuals, they are seeking for answers. Excuse me. But they can't even discover, they don't even know where in this world, where in this book, the answer they need is located. In other words, somebody is looking for, Lord, I want my grades to be better. I have been taught that there is answer in this book. Where do I check? So it starts from Genesis. Am I going to read to Revelation before I find it? That was what led, excuse me, that was what led to the books we've been giving out to a number of students. How to study the Bible effectively. How you can study the Bible to get whatsoever you want. That book written by our mommy in the faith, Pastor Mrs. Faith Oyedepo. That's why we've been giving out the books. That use it to be a guide to how you can study the Bible and get what you want from it. I trust the Lord God of heaven that whatsoever you search for from now in this book, the Holy Spirit will guide you to it. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The Holy Spirit will guide you to it. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. However, when we disconnect from the foundation, that is the foundation of this world, we become utterly helpless in taking full possession of our inheritance in Christ. That is why in Psalm 11 and verse 3, the scripture says, if the foundation be destroyed, what can the righteous do? Once the foundation is gone, the building must come down. Whatsoever affects the foundation affects the entire structure. My father of blessed memory was a builder in his lifetime. And then he had a project. And as a little boy, I went with him one time to site. And I saw this house when it was completed. Beautiful house. Beautiful, at least to my little boy's mind. Beautiful house. And then one night, this man came back from work. And he sat down and he looked dejected. And my mom was asking him, what happened? He said, you know, the project in so-and-so site, he said, something happened and we will need to shift it a little bit. And I was like, shift it? What's the big deal? After all, I build all manner of houses in the sand by myself. And when I need to shift it, I shift it at will. And I reconstruct it. There's no big deal. So I felt to shift it, there was no big deal. But shifting that house, as he said it, because I couldn't comprehend why he should feel sad about shifting a house. He was the one who built it. Shifting the house means breaking it block by block to the foundation and rebuilding from ground up. If the foundation be destroyed, the destiny is lost. If the foundation be destroyed, the destiny is lost. If the foundation be destroyed, the destiny is lost. This is why Jesus Christ remains the foundation of true success. Jesus Christ remains the everlasting foundation of true success. And when we pay attention to his instructions, we are qualified for supernatural breakthrough. When we pay attention to his instructions, we become qualified for supernatural breakthrough. In Matthew chapter 5 and verse 18, his word says, for verily I say unto you, till heaven and earth pass, he said, one jot or one tittle shall in no wise pass from the law till all be fulfilled. Heaven and earth can pass away, he said, not a jot, not a dot, not a word of his word will pass away unfulfilled. In verse 19, it says, whosoever therefore shall break one of these least commandments and shall teach men so, he shall be called the least in the kingdom of God. What does that mean? You know, I've said it a number of times. Every scripture you break turns back to break you. You break a scripture, it turns round to come and break you. You break a scripture, you turn round to come and break you. You break a scripture, he turns around to come and break you. I've been having one very funny, humorous conversation recently. And I said, okay, let's do an exercise in Amos 3:3. Amos 3:3 simply says, can two walk together except they be agreed? If I'm going to the north and you are going to the south, automatically, we cannot be companions. If I try it, I will lose my track. You are going to south, I'm going to north. No, we cannot be journey mates. Each one must find his or her own way separately. I need a mate who is also going to the north. If I don't want to be derailed. If I have made up my mind to stand with Christ, and you have also made up your mind not to stand with him, then we cannot be friends. If we do, by any reason, I am in trouble. I will lose my way. I will lose it. I will lose it. If I don't want to lose it, therefore, I cannot be a companion of someone who is not going to the place that I'm going to. I can't be a companion with anyone who is not going to the place I'm going. If I break that scripture, Amos 3:3, as simple as it is, it will not be long before that scripture will turn around to break me. For example, the scripture says, everyone that is born again is a new creature. It says, old things are passed away. behold, all things have become what? Have become new. Let me give you a life application of this scripture. Thank you, studio. 2 Corinthians chapter 5 and verse 17. If I am unequally yoked with an unbeliever, in other words, if I'm a child of God and I have an unbeliever as my friend, let's say one of those friendship that you call relationship. You know, some of you don't know what relationship is. Okay. If I am a believer and the other person is not, that means I'm already on equally yoke with an unbeliever. And I'm already breaking that scripture. When God wants to deal with me, the believer, see what will happen. Suddenly, this unbeliever is going to meet with the grace of salvation. You know, Jesus Christ desired that everyone comes to the knowledge of the truth. And he does not wish for anyone to perish. So salvation will locate him one day, sooner than I expect. You know, I'm unequally yoked with him when he was an unbeliever. And you know what many of us will say? You say, I will pray and convert him. What a fallacy. There is none, human being on the face of the earth, that has the capacity to convert an ant. Conversion is the work of the Spirit of God. The Holy Spirit is the one that convicts. No man can ever do that. Okay, now, and then in the time that we are doing the relationship together, we are doing what is wrong. Now, suddenly this brother, most times, now meets the Lord. This scripture will just come alive to him like a shot out of the blue. That's 2 Corinthians chapter 5 and verse 17. We just come to him. Wham! You know the first thing that will happen to him is for him to now check the old things in his life that must pass away. The number one item on his list is you, that you are equally yoked with him. He will just discover that suddenly, wow. So you mean you know all these things and you did not show me and you agree with me to be doing what was wrong. He will ask God, say, God, I am sorry. You know I did not know. Please separate me and this individual. He will pray that prayer. Now the Holy Spirit will give him the boldness. He will meet with you and tell you straight, say, well, I praise the name of the Lord. Now I have found the grace of salvation. All things must pass away and you are in my hold. You are part of my whole things. Please, I need a break from you. And that break is not temporary. He will tell you point blank, I need a permanent, indelible separation from you forever. Please don't come to my house again. Case closed. The scripture you broke before will still turn around to come and break you. Practical life application of the word. So each time we turn our back against the foundation of his word, at some point, that foundation deals with you. That's why the scripture says, if the foundation be destroyed, what can the righteous do? Absolutely nothing. Therefore, my counsel is this. If anyone is in any unholy relationship, put a stop before your destiny is stopped. Put a stop now when your heart will not be broken. Put a stop now when there is still remedy. Don't wait until you become second-class citizen before you put a stop to it. And the sisters must take counsel. Pardon me for using this language this morning. The man and the woman, they don't have the same shelf life. You may not agree to it, but the man has a longer shelf life than the woman. The woman's shelf life is short. There is a time they call you Miss This, Miss That, Miss This. That's M-I-S-S. There is a time it gets to even you yourself. You will remove one S and throw away the I. You become M-S. You will just tell everybody, no, I'm not M-I-S-S. You remove one S, you remove one I, it remains M-S. The man, they call him Mr. Till he can become Mr. till he meets his maker. And it is okay. But for you, it may not be okay. Therefore, now that it is still okay, take counsel. Take counsel. Have had to minister to a large number of sisters in their 40s. And what is the project? Life partner. And then I will ask, do you mean nobody ever came since you were growing up? No, people came. And you know, when you use the person that should be your husband as your boyfriend, you are in trouble. Is a trouble. To use the person that should be your husband as boyfriend is trouble. Because when you lose boyfriend, that husband that is meant to be boyfriend, now you look for husband again, you will see many, many boyfriends. Boyfriends don't take anybody to the altar. Only husbands do. Praise the living Jesus. Praise the living Jesus. Now, that is my counsel for the sisters. And you know one thing, people of God, I have many, many daughters in the Lord than sons. So I should know. And I should be able to tell you. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. Remember, people of God, that we belong to the tops as end time believers. This is the reason we need to locate what to do and what is required of us to take full delivery of our breakthrough heritage in Christ. We need to locate it. That's why it is good for you to go into a search. You know, I've been telling our graduating class that discover your vision before you leave this place. Discover your purpose. Because inside your vision is everything you will ever need in life, including husband, including wife, including children. Your vision will tell you how many children you should have. Mine told me. Because your vision is God's plan for your life. The reason why God has created you is what is called vision. And you cannot create it. You only discover it. If you don't discover it, you will be doing what does not add any value to you in the real sense of it. You will be doing what does not add value to you in the real sense of it. You will be doing what does not add value to you in the real sense of it. That is why when I see young persons, guys say, no, I'm going to be singing. You want to be singing hip-hop. No, you don't decide to sing hip-hop. If God calls you into that hip-hop ministry, great. You go into it, you become instant success. Go and find out how many individuals have released one single and they have remained single all their lives. They have never done double. Not once. Not once. See, they just remain single all their entire lifetime. They release one and there is no one following it. Because the one they release, nobody is even going to listen to it. Even his own brother will not listen to it. Because he is not called into it. What you are not called into, you will be pushing it by yourself. But what God called you into, when you do it, he helps you to push it. And when he pushes it for you, it becomes an instant success. It becomes an instant success. Now, go and find out how many young men had gone to Europe because they want to go and do what they call that, they want to play football, okay? Or what Americans call soccer, if they're in US, you know, and then they need to go for assessment. Go and find out how many of them will never see any football pitch to play. Not to talk about that they will know them like now the Messi. Go and find out how many of them. If God has not called you into it, if you go into it, you are your own. That is how critical vision is. Glory be to God. Now let's look at the power of faith. Hebrews chapter 11 and verse 1. The Bible says, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. In verse 2, it says, for by it the elders obtain a good result, a good report. When you operate in faith, the only outcome is good report. The only outcome of faith is good report. Because faith is a legal tender in any land. You can buy anything in this world with the currency of faith. Faith is current anytime it is applied. What is faith? Faith is believing the word of God enough for you to take step on it. Faith is believing the word enough for you to take step on it. Faith is not chanting of scriptures. Faith is not recitation. They don't recite faith, they only recite poems. When you have faith, you have good report to show, because there is a word upon which you are standing that determines the steps that you are taking. A number of persons had met with me, adults, to say, we are going to this line of business, we are going to start this piece, and then I will ask, on which word are you standing? Because if you say it is God that has commanded it, then you must have a word to back it up. When you don't have a word, then I know you are not ready to start. Because the word he gives you, that's what comforts you and empowers you to overcome any opposition that you meet on the way. If anybody ever tells you that you will not meet opposition on your life journey, the person has told you the biggest of all lies. Jesus Christ met his own. He overcame by the power of the word inside of him. The first time the devil came to him, he released the salvos of three powerful scriptures at him, and he beat him hands down. That is faith, operating according to the word of God. And when you do, what happens is good report. In Hebrews 11, if you get to verse 4, then you will see that everyone that made it in scripture made it by faith. In verse 2, it says, for by it the elders obtained a good report. Now let's look at some of these elders. Verse 4, it says, by faith, Abel. In other words, the good report Abel had happened on the platform of faith. In verse 5, it says, by faith, Enoch. In verse 7, it says, by faith, Noah. Now, Noah built an ark that no one, he was the first. Yet, he didn't go to any school where they learned shipbuilding. He didn't study shipbuilding engineering. All the best engineers of this world put their heads together to build Titanic. Yet, Titanic sank. But Noah did not go to any school of shipbuilding or shipbuilding engineering, whether civil or building or technology. He didn't go to any. Yet he built an ark that floated and never sank. An ark that had the capacity to keep the sheep and the lion, and lion did not devour the sheep. Why? He operated on the word of God. Each time you step out on the word, everything works well for you. Each time you step out on the word. In verse 8, it says, by faith, Abraham. Verse 11, through faith, also Sarah. Verse 20, by faith, Isaac. Verse 21, by faith, Jacob. 22, by faith, Joseph. 23, by faith, Moses. Even Jericho, in verse 30, fell down by faith. In other words, even opposition will give way when you operate by faith. In other words, each time you engage faith, you become successful on the subject of your attention. Operating in faith. Operating in faith. Operating in faith. And each time you are not operating in faith, you disqualify yourself from the help of God. What you are saying, each time you don't operate in faith, is that God cannot do it. Let me try by myself. You know, they say it erroneously. They say, everyone helps those who help themselves. And they say it's in the scripture. It's not true. That's not true. It's not there. It's not there. It is the help of God that can see a man through the journey of life. And that comes by the operation of faith, which means relying heavily on the word of God. Relying heavily on the word of God. I was saying it last night, when we started a walk, all right, to do the narrative of Canaan land. How Canaan land, a forest uninhabitable and uninhabited at some point, has now suddenly become the center of attraction. And I told that my other colleague, I said, no, we need to do the narrative of this place. So we started it last year. So I said, look, let's come together and let's complete this work. We need to do the narrative because it is the narrative of the power of faith. He said, this place is not good for church, but God said, it is high. He said, no, he just told me it is high. And then come and see what the Lord has done. Come and see what the Lord has done. Come and, by now, second service had already started inside the same forest. Second service had already started inside the same forest. And inside the same forest has come the good report. The largest single church congregation on a Sunday, on the face of the earth. In other words, as vast as this earth is, from time till now, there is no place where human beings gather for worship service in the number that we gather here at the Faith Tabernacle. Yet, it was a forest just a few years back. A forest that nobody dared to enter just a few years back. That is the triumph of faith. Each time you engage with faith, you live a triumphant life, and that is without stress. You will get there in the name of Jesus Christ. You will get there in the name of Jesus Christ. And very quickly, let's look at the power of meekness. How does meekness help us to arrive at the point of supernatural breakthrough? Glory be to God. In Matthew chapter 5 and verse 5, the Bible says, blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. In other words, there is nothing on the face of the earth that becomes impossible for the meek to get. Absolutely nothing on the face of the earth that becomes impossible for the meek to get. When you live in pride, you are denied your right. When you live in pride, you are denied your right. You are denied your right. You are denied your right. When you live in pride, you are denied what truly belongs to you. You are denied what truly belongs to you. The prodigal son, one of the things that almost killed him was pride. Ordinarily, the father needs to die before you collect your inheritance. Is that not true? It's after the man is gone. That's when they read his will. But the boy said, let that tradition go to places, not me. I want to collect my own when you are still alive. The father said, no, it is not done. He said, that's how I want to live my own life. You can live your life anyhow you like, but my own, I want to live it this way. Give me what belongs to me or I blow your head off. The dad said, no verse. Take it. I will wait and see what happens. Each time you kick against the word of God, is laid down principles, something negative happens at the end of the day. If not for the merciful God, his destiny was lost completely. He was struggling to eat with pigs. Now, do you know how dirty and how smelly pigs are? Now, can you now imagine how smelly the food they eat will be? Because it is what you eat inside that hits you on the outside. He was struggling to eat that, and they did not even allow him to eat it. That's for you to see that the proud does not have a place. Does not have a place. The proud does not have a place. Pride is a sinker. Pride is a sinker. It is pride that makes someone to desire what his colleagues or our colleagues have. He said, look at his bottle green shoes. Look at our bottle green shoes. And you have lemon green shoes. Green is green, whether bottle or lemon. But it is pride that wants you to acquire what you don't have capacity to afford. You are all from different homes. And as they say, fingers are not equal, except the one that they slice to become equal. All right? And if you don't want yours to be, leave your size per time, you will enjoy life. You will enjoy life. You will enjoy life. You will enjoy life. You may be earning 5,000 naira per month today from your parents. Give glory to God for it. Somebody may not get anything at all. If you look at your colleague that is collecting 50,000 naira, you will steal. If you steal, they catch you, they will deal with you. I live a contented life per time. Contented life per time. I'm always excited, you know, with whatsoever I have per time. It is your headache to find out where did he buy it, how much is it. That's your headache. It's not mine. It's not mine. It's not mine. Some people came to me and said they wanted to do something fashion and they want me to come and do. I said, I don't do fashion. I dress as is comfortable to me per time. I dress as is comfortable to me per time. Now, by Tuesday, I may be thinking, say, to find out the color of suit I wore on Sunday. Most time, I don't remember, so I wear anything I see. I wear the shirt that my hands touches, and I'm gone. It doesn't bother me whether it's the same color I wore yesterday or not. Color for what? Even my father in the faith, he has made it simple. Okay? He just wears white all of the time. You can't even tell whether he has changed it in 3 months. Whether it's the same one he wore yesterday, is wearing today, and be wear tomorrow, is your own cup of tea. The man has put it on, he has gone his own way. He said he does not have the time to think which color of dress did I wear yesterday to now know what to wear today. Pride is a sinker. Pride is a sinker. Pride is a sinker. Pride is a sinker. That was what led to one boy's expulsion from this university. His dad lost his job. And they were living in the quarters of the organization where they were working before. Very beautiful place, like an estate. Now, the dad lost his job and now moved. He was already building. He had a building. Okay? And the dad felt, before I pay you guys school fees, instead of committing this huge amount of money to rent an apartment, let's do something in our own site and move in and then be building it as we go on. And they got there, and the boy lost his school. He said, I can't imagine that we'll be living in this kind of neighborhood. What do you mean by neighborhood? What the Bible says is a roof over your head. Bible does not talk about neighborhood. And because of that, the boy became depressed. And he will be walking aimlessly on campus. And now, one enemy of his destiny located him one day. And said, why are you looking downcast? He said, I'm tired of life. I said, no. I will give you something that will make you to look up. That was exactly the way the person put it to him. And that thing that will make him look up was what made them throw him away. I'm not sure he had taken it for a long time before they discovered there was another substance in his bloodstream. And so as a result of that, he was expelled. when I now call him, have you now helped your dad? Or you have compounded his woes? Most of the time, what you call pride, what you call depression, is pride. What is depressing you? What is depressing you? The place where you are now, somebody is praying for it as a testimony. Somebody is looking up to you and say, God, just make me like this person. Just make me like this person. Just make me like this person. That is the prayer of somebody. Yet, here you are. You look at yourself and you are like, God, why am I like this? And somebody, some of you will pray, say, God, why are you doing this to me? Who are you that God is doing something to? What do you, what is your worth that God is doing something to? God has not seen people like Bishop Oyedepo there to go and do something to them. He has not seen Baba Adeboye to go and do something to them. Kenneth Copeland to do many things to them. Those ones, when they do something to them, people will know. When anything they do to you, nobody knows. Nobody knows. Nobody knows. You know the reason we did not, you know when they say artsmen kill 50 people, they kill, you know, the people they kill is the reason it continues. You understand? They kill one that should not be killed. That evil stops immediately. The reaction will be too great. So we need to understand what it means. Don't allow pride to sink your destiny. There is a place you are going. Whatsoever you don't have today, you may become the manufacturer of it tomorrow. You may become the manufacturer of it tomorrow. The shoes you don't have today, you will be a major supplier or major producer of it tomorrow. So don't kill yourself today. Don't kill yourself today. Somebody will take the ATM card of his friend, and you say he's your friend. And we now go to the machine. And then you put it in, you check. This individual has only 25,000 in that account. And you now withdraw 24,000. And you say, he's your friend. And the man, the person is looking, you say, did you see my ATM card? He say, ah, I have never seen it in my life. But you have just gone there to go and withdraw the money. His pride, be contented with what you have. If you don't have pride, you will ask, say, dear, my dear, please, oh, they have not sent my money. Can you please help me? Which is more honorable for you to take what does not belong to you? And if he now says it is 500 naira I can give you, you receive it with thanksgiving. You say, God, I thank you for this 500 naira. And if I were you, I will even pay tithe out of that 500 naira. Yes, as I do that, it will keep more flowing my way. I won't know drought. I won't know drought. As long as I do that. As long as I do that. You won't see evil in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You won't see evil in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You will not see evil in the name of Jesus Christ. According to Proverbs chapter 16 and verse 18, the Bible says, pride goeth before destruction. Pride goeth before destruction. And an haughty spirit before a fall, you will not fall. In Jesus' mighty name, rise up on your feet. Lift up your hand before the Lord this morning and just give him thanks. Lift up your hands. Give him thanks this morning. Magnify him for the word that has come your way today. Glorify the Almighty. And now receive grace to discover your own path in the word of God. To make discovery in the word that will enhance the fulfillment of your destiny. That you will not be following the path that will not lead to your own place in destiny. Receive that grace this morning from the Lord. Receive that grace this morning from the Lord. Receive that grace this morning from the Lord. And receive the grace from God to deal with every trace of pride in your life. Because pride is a sinker, it is a destroyer of destiny. Receive grace from him today to deal with every trace of pride. Every trace of pride. Pride will not let you see God. Pride will not let you get to the place that has been ordained for you. Receive that grace this morning. Receive that grace this morning. Receive that grace this morning. Lord, let this grace come upon every one of us. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. Very quickly, before we leave here this morning, if you have not given your life to Christ, that is where the journey begins from. John chapter 3 and verse 16, the scripture says, God so loved the world, and he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever will believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. New birth is your gateway to everlasting life. New birth is your gateway to everlasting life. Until a man or a woman is born again, he has not begun the journey at all. Living on this earth is not the end of life. After this time out, there is another place. It is called eternity. Where you spend that eternity is a function of what you do here on the earth. Everyone who is a child of God is qualified to be in eternity. But if you are not, then you become disqualified from it. But God did not come for any, Jesus did not come for anyone to perish. He has been sent here to be a blessing to mankind. All you need to do is to embrace him, and then you become a partaker of that blessing. If you are here this morning and you have not met the Lord Jesus, allow me to pray for you this day. And everything will become right for you. You also will be a partaker of the blessings that Jesus Christ brought with him. Let there be quiet, please. You need to say yes to Jesus. Wherever you are standing this morning, lift up your right hand and let me pray with you. Until you do, you can't access the blessing of God. We have come here this morning to meet with our Maker, who has the capacity to give you what you need in order to live live in the weak without trouble. That is the blessing he has in store for all of his children. It would be great for you to be a partaker of that this day. Lift up your right hand, let me pray with you. And then if you know you were with him before, but even now you are doing one leg in, one leg out, and that won't help you. That won't help you. You need to rededicate your life to him, and you know it. Until you do, life does not have meaning. The value in life is the one that is lived in Christ. You need to rededicate your life also this morning. Lift up the same right and let me pray with you this morning. Everything will become right with you. You will be a partaker of the blessings in Jesus Christ. Lord, you identify those hands. You identify those souls. Thank you for them, Almighty God. I pray this morning that your saving grace will locate each one of them in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And as you recover them this morning, Almighty God, cause them to live in this decision all their lives in the name of Jesus Christ. Almighty God, if anything has gone wrong because of where they were before, Jesus, I pray that such be corrected from this day in the name of Jesus Christ. Give to each one of them a brand new beginning. A brand new beginning in righteousness, a brand new beginning in right living, and a brand new beginning in right standing with you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Almighty God. Blessed be thy holy name. In Jesus' great name, we have prayed. Glory be to God. You prayed that prayer, or you did not even pray that prayer, but you know you need to appropriate it. Please step to the front. Let's complete the assignment very quickly. Glory be to God. Very quickly. Jesus is waiting for you. Very quickly, step to the front. That is what is called the step of faith. The step of faith. Step to the front very quickly. And let's complete that assignment. very quickly, smartly, and quickly. Let's complete. Let there be quiet in the house. Quiet in the house. Jesus is waiting for you this morning. He wants to make it right for you. He wants to give you a brand new beginning. He wants to give you a brand new beginning. In actual fact, he has given you the brand new beginning. Come and collect the keys to it. Come and collect the keys to it. To your brand new beginning this morning. To your brand new beginning this morning. To your brand new beginning this morning. Jesus is waiting for you. He wants to make it right for you. He wants to make it right for you. Living cannot continue the way it is. For how long are you going to live without hearing from the Spirit of God? Without having the conviction that he is by you? Without the assurance that you are in the will of God? He's waiting this morning to make it right for you. And I trust him as you take the step, he will keep you in his righteousness by his mighty hand in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ.